There are over 3,000 recorded plant species within South Carolina. The state's variety of natural habitats and geographic size make it one of the most diverse areas for flora in the nation. In this botanical utopia, there's a wide range of colors, sizes, and shapes. Their adaptations vary from mechanical defenses such as thorns and spines to brightly hued flowers more easily detected by insects for pollination. Others have come up with some fascinating wild ways of taking adaptation to an entirely new level. Carnivorous plants, also known as insectivorous plants, are distinguished from other plants by their ability to capture and digest insects or other small animals. Often mistaken, carnivorous plants do not eat their prey for energy. Rather, they digest animals to get the needed nutrients absent in the soil of their environment. While this adaptation may seem like an upgrade, there are some disadvantages. Their modified leaves, used to trap their prey, are not as efficient at capturing the sunlight necessary for photosynthesis. Because of this, carnivorous plants require a bright, sunny environment and don't compete well against other plants. The most easily recognized carnivorous plant, the Venus flytrap, is native to nowhere else but the Carolinas. It has the rarest active mechanism in carnivorous plants, known as the snap trap. The trap is comprised of two specialized leaves with slender trigger hairs that are activated when bent. Once the trap is activated, the leaves seal shut, releasing digestive juices to break down its food. Like the Venus flytrap, the pitcher plant secretes sweet-smelling nectar to attract insects near its peristome, or rim. The slippery surface near the pitcher plant's mouth causes the prey to fall inside its funnel-like body. This passive approach, known as a pitfall trap, prevents animals from escaping with downward-pointing hairs lined along the inner wall of the plant. Inevitably, the prey will drown in the fluid-filled cavity and be digested. One of the most unique carnivorous plants in South Carolina is the sundew. Also known as Drosera, the sundew plant has tiny tentacle-like hairs covering its leaves that are tipped with what looks like a drop of dew. These glistening dewdrops are actually a sticky mucilage substance secreted by the plant that act as an adhesive. When the glandular tentacles are touched, adjacent tentacles bend gradually towards the struggling prey. Special enzymes are then secreted in order to break down the catch and absorb its nutrients. There are approximately 31 species of carnivorous plants in South Carolina. Some of them are exceedingly rare, and like many plants, are in decline and have become a protected species. Major threats to carnivorous plants include habitat alterations, poaching, and invasive or competitive species. Since 1976, groups like the South Carolina Department of Natural Resources have been able to protect these plants by establishing nature preserves. Today, there are 76 preserves covering nearly 100,000 acres statewide. Conservation efforts include prescribed burnings to eliminate unhealthy competition, tracking rare plants in a database for wildlife management planning, and reintroducing species into their natural habitat. These critical actions help these ferocious yet delicate plants continue to flourish and allow everyone to enjoy their beauty in the wild.